My name is Jeanette Shikali. I am the executive director of the Panamanian Foundation for the Promotion of Mathematics Funda Bromat. Oh no, I was not natural with mathematics. In fact, I needed my dad's help. So he was the one who explained math to me, but he did it in a fun way, like using games and magic tricks and puzzles. So he was the one who was responsible for me to really love mathematics. And then I started challenging myself, so I loved it even more. I got a Bachelor of Science in Mathematics and Chemistry from the University of Notre Dame. For a summer, I took an RU program in chemistry. And then the next summer, I took an RU program in mathematics. And for those of you who don't know, RU is an undergraduate research experience. And when I took my RU program in mathematics, it was spectacular. So that's when I decided that I wanted to do a PhD in mathematics. And the reason is because they gave us a different problem to solve every single day. And I would solve these math problems with my friends. So it was all about teamwork. So I loved it. So at the Panamanian Foundation for the Promotion of Mathematics, Funda Promat, we work on changing the world's perception so that one and all can perceive mathematics as accessible, relevant, and inherently joyous. It sounds intense, but basically what we do is that we spread the joy of mathematics to everybody. So that's what I do. I spread the joy of mathematics. I love sharing my passion for mathematics with others. Now, as the executive director, I also get to solve different kinds of problems. So there's also a lot of mathematics involved in that. Many people are surprised to learn that I failed my first calculus exam while I was in the university. And I mean failed as an F, not fail like D or no. It was real fail as an F. And so maybe I should give you a little bit more background information. So I actually won a bronze medal and a gold medal in the Panamanian Math Olympics while I was a student. So technically, I thought that I was really good at math, technically, because that's what it's supposed to mean. But then when I got to the university and I failed my first calculus exam, it was like the end of the world for me. I was like, what does this mean about me? I thought I was good at math. So I had two choices. I could either decide to go back to Panama and give up, or I could ask for help. And of course, now that I have a PhD in mathematics, I think you can guess what I decided to do. And yes, I asked for help. My proudest accomplishment is definitely creating my own private nonprofit foundation, Funda Promat. So how did this come about? It's an interesting story, actually. So after I got my PhD in mathematics, I came back to Panama and I worked for 7 years in the National Secretariat of Science, Technology, and Innovation of Panama, SENASID, which is part of the Panamanian government. And during that time, I created a program on math outreach, which was a huge success. So we brought invited speakers to Panama to give talks that were open to the general public. And it was super exciting because we had to add extra chairs to the events. And even when we added extra chairs, there were people still standing in the back. So anyway, it was a huge success. But then we had presidential elections in 2019, and we had new authorities come, and these authorities had new priorities. And suddenly, the program on math outreach was not a priority. So then that's when I decided that I had to create an organization that was independent of the government, of any other education center, schools, universities, et cetera, so that we could continue doing what we had seen. It wasn't only necessary, but people were asking for it. So that's how Funda Promat was born. Since I already mentioned my dad, I think I'm going to mention somebody else now. And that person would definitely have to be my PhD thesis advisor, Dr. Sarah Witherspoon from Texas A&M University. She basically changed my life because she believed in me before I believed in myself. And that's very powerful. Of course, I didn't know this at the time. I knew this later on. And now that we've met again at the math conferences, it's been fantastic reconnecting with her. But during the time that I was a student, she was such a patient and she was always wanting to help whatever I needed. And I heard the stories of other graduate students that did not have those great connections with their PhD thesis advisors. So one suggestion for those who are interested in studying a PhD in mathematics is make sure that you choose your PhD thesis advisor carefully. Think a lot about it because it is very important. So I actually have three recommendations for anyone who's listening to me right now. So the first one would be, once you find your passion, embrace it. The second one is, if your dream job does not exist, create it. And the third one is that throughout all of this process, make sure that you take care of yourself.